Yes, indeed. The richest off in this thing, man. What's happening with y'all? This video is going to be our out of the theater, straight out of the theater response or reaction to A Quiet Place Day One. Kind of excited about this movie. Quiet Place One was really good. Quiet Place Two was okay. But I just want to show y'all this theater before we do our out of the theater reaction. It's the Regal Atlantic Station. And they just, if y'all can see my background, they just got a lot of, it's nice. They must have refurbished this because when me and Kiki went to, last time we went to this theater was years ago, bro. And I promise you, on everything I love, they did not have all of this. They did not have all this nice looking stuff, bro. So Kiki over here getting some, where's she at? She's supposed to be getting some refreshment. We just left dinner. Even look at the menus, bro. Look at the menus. They got like moving menus and stuff like that. That's crazy. Yeah, they're moving. Yeah, they're moving. And there's my wife. So hey, the Rich Nation. I mean, Rich Family. Yeah, so I was just telling them they must have refurbished and did a lot of stuff since the last time.
Because it don't look nothing like what I remember.
And before we
now
do,
I ain't gonna lie, they much more expensive, so they should be. They giving us something.
Yeah,
and it's, last time they got I came a, here, it wasn't this expensive.
They got a few different formats on how to watch movies in too. So before we do the Quiet Place reaction, I just kind of want to show y'all the movie theater a little bit. Sounds good.
Yep.
So they got so many ways you can see a movie here, bro. They got the IMAX joint going on. Then you walk down here, and this is the one we going to see, The Quiet Place. And right here, it's called Screen X. So I read a little description of it online, and it said it's kind of like a more immersive type thing. We'll let y'all see what we're talking about if we can when we get in there and kind of explain it. And like I said, I never see, y'all comment below if y'all movie theaters got these right here. This one says 4DX, and I don't even know if they got it yet. Oh, it's, baby, this one, babe, how's she going to stay all the way down here while I'm explaining? Come here. She's like, you go ahead and do that. I'm going to chill down here. This says motion seats and environment effects. Motion, oh, water, like, fog, wind, vibration, lightning,
sense. I believe that. I think that's like a really good thing for like a kid movie or something. Or anything like,
man,
a
kids.
Jurassic Park or something.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Like, yeah. Jurassic Park. But this is dope. This is by far one of the dopest movie theaters I've seen. The only thing about it is when I was reading up on it, they said the reclining chairs wasn't in all of them. So we're going to see if ours got it.
But you know what? Mm-hmm. I'll come back with the determination. I know we got to see Deadpool by the end of next month. But I want to know, like, now understanding what that 4DX is after I watch this. Because this would be a new experience. We'll decide.
Is it a waiting? Is it a waiting? I'm sorry.
I was just saying we'll decide which one you want to see that in.
Yeah, because is it a way they can do the 4DX, the IMAX, and the in one screen?
I don't know. That might send you down.
Yeah, it might be too much. It might be sensory overload. Yeah, I don't know. But anyway, like I said, we are going to see it in Screen X, and then we'll kind of show y'all and give y'all a if it's any better than a regular movie. So anyway, A Quiet Place.
Hey guys, this is an example of the immersive experience. We'll talk about it more once the movie ends.
Hey guys, so Quiet Place Day One is over.
It is. Look at the seats. Little drip, little black and red dripping here.
And even though I did a voiceover before, I showed them the wall again because this whole entire wall, all the way up to the top on each side, is playing the whole movie. So when we come back, we're going to try to sit at the top just so we can get the full experience. But
since the screen goes all the way around and they call it. Well, I said it before we came in. Yo.
I forget too, but it's not important right now. But I think what I would recommend is like really high-paced, like action movies. Like if we would have saw Bad Boys in here, it would have been a whole nother level. Like, because this movie wasn't necessarily, it didn't necessarily benefit from it. We could have just been one screen. But it was a really, really good experience. So getting to the movies, what were your thoughts, right?
It was A Quiet Place movie, like you said earlier.
I definitely.
The first one to me gonna always be the best one.
Mm-hmm.
Second one was cool, but it wasn't good as the first one. And I put this probably the same with the second one. You know what I'm saying?
You know what?
It's a whole different story, and it wasn't involving that same family no more. So
right, I don't think anything can take away. Now I'll be honest in saying, before you take my advice, I have never been from the first movie a big huge fan of this franchise, period. Right. Like, from the first movie, I said it was just okay to me. Right. I do think the actor, I forgot her name right now, but she played the hell out of her part.
And this one?
She did too. Lupita was in this one, but I'm talking about the very first one. She had to have a baby. She had to go through a whole bunch of stuff, and she played that movie. But I don't love movies. I ain't gonna say hate. I don't love movies that don't give me enough of the story.
Kiki, like, dialogue.
I need to understand because even with this one, they set it up so you get kind of like an idea of what happened and why number one and two. And then I did love the fact that they used same characters from like this one and number two. I was able to identify some or whatever, so it kind of brought the story together. But I'm still really lost on the whys. Like, I need somebody to just write it down on paper at this point. If you just can't speak or talk or whatever, just write it down. Let me just get that out my system.
You want it to have a explanation where these things come from.
Weren't we able to stop them? And you know, like, it didn't give me enough of this. This was actually a very sad story.
Emily Blunt. Emily Blunt was the actress.
Emily Blunt. Yes, she did her thing. This was a very sad story to me. When I think about this story, it was just hopeless, like, for one of the characters. And it was just like, no matter what, it wasn't going to work out well for her.
But it was character-driven.
Was definitely character-driven. Yeah. But it still could have been more, because even after she met her friend, it was still kind of like, his story wasn't passionate enough for me to really care about.
He barely had a story.
So I still feel like it just could have been some more engaging writing to really just bring even the story together. Because I won't lie, the main character, I did care about her plight. We did get enough. We understood. But honestly, she was sick. We know what her sickness was, but you don't know what her sickness was. So it was just a lot of...
You wanted to know that?
I did.
She was terminally ill, so that's all I need to know.
I know, but I guess for me, I'm just a different personality. You can be terminally ill, but what was it? You know what I'm saying? Like,
I was more concerned with... I thought it was going to go more into the background, because they had a scene... And I don't even want to spoil it. It's a small scene. It ain't going to spoil it. But it was just had a scene kind of, they showed like the little nesting grounds. And it was like, I wanted them to elaborate on where these things come from. Maybe it being a mystery, they figured it'd be more scary that way.
Exactly.
And it did a really good job at building tension, which all the movies do.
All of them do a great job with that. I felt like the tension, the pacing, I felt like all of those things work well with this movie. You're definitely going to be on the edge of your seat, because it's so much like, boom, boom, this is happening over here. And then, like I said, they did well with having a story. The story could have just been a little bit more strong, a little bit more brought together for my taste, or whatever. Because when you do an origin story, to me, I feel like that's the perfect time for you to be able to explain. And we quickly understood in this movie that you had to be quiet. Right. That was cool. But I needed, until we got into that, I needed a reason, like a news report running in the background, something to tell me, you know what I'm saying? This is the best thing. They did give us a tip, you know what I'm saying, for people who were trying to survive to get to, you know what I'm saying, a place or whatever, so that they could, because the monsters couldn't tolerate the water. But it still wasn't like, you know, like they could, I mean, we had the helicopters that time telling people to evacuate, but it still was not enough to say, hey, this is happening. This is why you need to be quiet. They're sensitive to this. I just needed the build up.
And that's the main thing that put it in the same category as a lot of these dystopian end of the world, everything is going down type of movies, because a lot of them, they just really rely on, okay, just accept that it's the end of the world and this is what these characters are going through.
Exactly.
While this stuff is happening. So you want to do scores?
Yeah, definitely do scores. I mean, I guess we're going to do a score of 1 to 10.
Yeah.
On the scale of 1 to 10, I'll give it a solid 6, maybe.
Okay.
5.5.
And I'm with you with that. I give it a straight up 5, just flat 5. Mm-hmm. Wasn't the best I've seen, wasn't the worst I've seen. It was entertaining, but it left a lot to be desired, in my opinion.
So you can definitely wait for Amazon Prime when it's free, when you don't have to pay the $20 for it.
With that being said, if you were a super big fan of the first two movies, I go to the movies and spend money to see this one.
Absolutely. And then I just think, like, if you like Lupita, she's a terrific. She gonna give you the face. She gonna give you. No. She gave me so many emotions and said barely
without
any
even
words.
Saying
that
anything.
Is like a talent that really like great. I don't think everybody. Her and Emily Blunt both did that tremendously well. So it was not a reflection of her at all. I try to definitely support women actors. But it was just the storytelling for me, like I said, and it's been the storytelling from the beginning of this franchise. I mean, of course, it's just certain stuff that you go check out just because me and him love to go to the movies, right. And we love a good date. And this is some, I mean, it was like, hey, the Quiet Place, we saw the other ones, let's go see it. But I gotta stick with my solid 5.5.
Yeah, I gave it a 5, and it was decent. So
yeah, it was. Some, if you just
this movie theater experience was.
Now this is worth it. I want to see what we can come see, that whatever is Deadpool, maybe.
Yeah, Deadpool Wolverine, yeah, something big like something that. Big and like sitting in the back, because this is one of the movie theaters that actually will sitting in the back will probably be the best choice.
Exactly, because it's just this whole experience. But the only thing I will say about these, they have nice, these seats do recline. It's kind of like you gotta push yourself back.
But they don't have the foot.
But it don't have the foot thing or whatever. So it's not like, so it kind
of. IMAX does.
It does. This kind of got uncle, but IMAX don't have this. So it's almost like with all of the experiences, you getting a trade off or whatever. Yeah. But would I come here? Definitely want to come back here again and experience like a big, huge action movie here, because I feel like it'll be like, you'll be so immersed in the situation. Epic. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I look forward to that. So anyways, don't want to talk too long. This is supposed to be a quick
out of the theater reaction, even though we're still in the theater. Of all quiet. We just wanted to do it while it was a quiet place, and right. We had to be outside and people walking by us and stuff like this. We're the last ones left.
Exactly. Right. They're like, what are they doing?
Yeah, but they should know in 2024 everybody record themselves, but exactly. They still act crazy. Anyway, that's it.
That's it. That's all I
that
got.
Was the review.
Yep.
So. Y'all go see it or not go see it. Wait for it to come on streaming.
Or if you've already seen it, let us know what you think. Yep. And we will see you guys soon.
Out of here.
Bye.